let's walk.
Alright, this is the driver's side rear quarter.
Okay.
Get a good shot up underneath of this truck. Get down and look up underneath the trunk. Gas tank still holds gas, still in good shape.
Yeah, 12 bolt rear end. Exhaust looked a hell of a lot better a few months ago. Looked brand new a few months ago.
Alright, come on up. Let's look in the trunk. These are extra door panels. This is the tilt steering column. Got keys in it. Got extra stuff all over the place. Headlight buckets, the rest of the trim, some door sill, a jack, the original jack, which is actually kind of hard to find. It's got extra hood hinges. The hood that's on it right now does not have hinges on the fenders because they used a fiberglass liftoff. All right, take this pin over here in this corner so they can see both shots of the trunk where it needs to be patched. Okay, yep, and then over here by the quarter, so they can see inside the quarter. And then come on outside the car and go down the side of the car. Okay, go right down the side of the car, show them the bottom of the quarter there, duck down. Yep, and then just walk right alongside the car. A good lower shot so they can see everything. Go up by that front door so they can see that front door piece. Alright, these fenders are not bolted on, they're just sitting on here. They are bolted, but they're not fitted on there and sitting on there properly. This is actually the 350 that's in the car right now, the original motor. I got it. The owner I got it from told me the motor has been rebuilt, and there is a four-barrel intake in the trunk for the car. I don't have a carb for it. This motor runs really good and strong. The exhaust was brand new. It's starting to turn already. Front of the car is in fairly decent shape. Look up here. Give them a good view right up here. Right up here is where the hood hinges are supposed to bolt. There are no hood hinge thingies. These are on the old fenders, but not on these fenders because they were using a fiberglass liftoff hood with this car. Okay. Come on around. Give them a good shot of the same position in that door right there. It's got the same problem up in the front. On down the car. We'll go ahead and open up and let them look inside. Up here in the front, it needs a floor pan patch on the left, the front, and right back here. I'd say just put a full front floor pan in driver's side. In the back, come back over here. Come back over here. Alright, now behind and underneath that seat in the far corner, there is a very small hole. It's right out, it's on the outboard side. So it does need a small patch about that big around, and it's underneath that seat in the far corner. The rest of the floor pans, is go ahead and pan across them. They're really good, really good shape. Frame's not bad either. All right. Seats were brand new. I got them out of North Carolina. They barely even been sat in yet. It's the Bench Buddy Fold. Give them a pan of the dash, I guess. I'm not too pleased about the CD player, but that's how I got it. The door panels aren't bad on the top two-thirds. The lower two-thirds need to be reattached, glued down. All right. Let's see if this pin will start up.